S-Clubber goes deep into the wild of a faraway country to search for an endangered animal. This week, we're going to show you my adventure when I went looking for the monk seal.
Name?
Hannah.
Height?
1.62 metres.
Diet?
Sweets.
Hobbies?
Swimming.
Skills?
Sleeping under my duvet.
Population?
One of seven of S-Club 7.
Name?
Mediterranean monk seal.
Height?
2.57 metres.
Diet?
Fish, eels and octopus.
Hobbies?
Swimming.
Skills?
Sleeping underwater.
Population?
One of 500 in the world. I'll be travelling to Turkey, land of ancient remains, belly dancing and kebabs. And I'll be accompanied by my fellow S-Clubber, Bradley.
Well, here we are in Turkey, Istanbul. We've arrived safe and sound.
So, what have you got in store for us? What are we going to be doing while we're here?
Well, we're going to check out a bit of the Turkish vibe.
All right.
See what goes on in Turkey.
So, we're here in Turkey, right, to see the monk seal, yeah?
That's correct.
So, how come you chose the monk seal?
The monk seal's got cute little watery eyes, and it's really cute. It's got a little blubbery neck.
Go to the hotel, get showered and changed and everything, and have a little kip.
I'm going to go shopping at the Grand Bazaar and get him a couple of little presents because it's actually his birthday. He's 19 years old. So I'm going to get him a few presents and then go back and surprise him.
Because Istanbul is on the coast, people here eat loads of fish, just like the monk seal. His favourite dish is octopus. Ugh.
Shopping.
I've just spotted the perfect present for Bradley, an alarm clock shaped like a mosque. That will have to be bought.
Right, the present barn's going really well. I've managed to get this. I think that's nice. And these. How much was that, please?
4 million.
4 million. Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Lovely. Perfect little present to finish off Bradley's little shopping spree. And then he can rub it and make his birthday wishes come true.
Woo! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, Bradley! What do you mean, what?
Right. Hey! Boy, yeah!
You got to put them
on. I have always wanted one of these.
You got to put them on.
Always wanted one of these, yeah. I'll put one on.
Hey.
Wicked. I've always wanted a pet.
They are.
Now I'm Aladdin. I could be Aladdin now. Oh, I've got my little lamp as well. Woo!
Come on then, Brad. Chop, chop. Got your presents. Go get out now. Come on.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay, okay.
Come on.
Okay, okay, okay.
Come on.
I ain't got nothing on. I'm making. So this is kebab land in here.
This is the heart of kebab land.
All right.
As you can see to our left, we have lots of kebabs.
Oh, cool.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, yeah.
Hello.
We got chicken kebab.
Yes. Okay. How many?
Two, please.
Two hot kebabs, please.
That looks tasty.
My belly's just
really
rumbling.
Really tasty.
Hey, mashallah, mashallah, nice kebab.
Oh. Here you go, Han. It's a profession to fall back on if you ever change your mind
exactly.
about pop
I'll
music.
Become a chef. Beautiful kebab.
Yes, very nice.
Nice kebab.
International chicken, please.
Stick it in there. Slap it over. Oh, dear.
This?
Roll it over like oops.
Bravo.
Hey!
You're quite good at that. For the first time, I think that's quite good.
No problem.
Toast it to perfection.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Here we go. We left Istanbul and headed out into the Turkish countryside. On the way, I saw what looked to be a castle on the map. Right. This looks very interesting.
It's a fine-looking place, just like in the middle of nowhere.
I know. I'm not sure really what it is, but there's a little splodge on the map here, and I think this might be it. I think we should take a little look inside.
Mad.
I think. I'm not sure, though. Hang on. Let's see if anyone's there. Well, no one's going to be there, are
they? I doubt it.
Oh, look. Oh!
I ain't going in.
Oh, come on. Come on. Come on, Bradley.
Spooky.
Look. There's people spinning. These spinning men are called whirling dervishes. They're performing a traditional ceremony developed in the 13th century, which is carried out to achieve a union with God. Dervish literally means doorway, and they are believed to be an entrance from the material world into the spiritual world. During the solemn ceremony, the power of the heavens enters the raised right arm, passes through the body, and leaves the lower arm entering the earth.
All right, okay.
Find interesting in that little spin.
And I can't really. All right. Yeah.
Oh no, I can't see what they see in there. With our heads spinning, we got back on the road deeper into the Turkish countryside towards a place called Cappadocia, also known as the Land of the Hidden Caves. A long time ago, violent volcanic eruptions covered Cappadocia with a thick layer of volcanic ash. This hardened and through the influence of wind and water erosion formed this unique landscape.
So, Han, what are we going to do later?
We're going to go, if you fancy it, we're going to go on some camels.
Oh, cool.
Yeah?
Well, we better hurry up, otherwise the camels might get the hump. I've got a camel joke for you, actually.
Go on, then.
What do you call a camel with three humps, Han?
Humphrey.
Never seen a camel in real life.
Have you not?
And now I'm going to get a chance to ride
one. I haven't, actually.
That is wicked. Careful, these things can spit.
So you're going to take us through the caves, then?
He can spit in my face. Look at the shape of his mouth, look. He's going to...
OK.
Right. Ooh.
Oh!
I don't weigh that much,
high.
Bro. Camel ride.
They're so wonky! Is yours wonky?
To the caves, Batman.
Oh. It's quite tiring. I'm not even doing anything. It's just hanging on for your dear life.
My butt is killing me.
I think we should head off home now, bud.
Definitely.
Maybe get the camels to take us home.
These pyramid-like formations have been home to people for centuries. Early settlers carved out the caves, and even now, people are living in them. I dragged Bradley out of bed at dawn to take one more look at the amazing landscape of Cappadocia. I'm glad to say that this mode of transport is a lot smoother than a camel ride.
Anna.
Yes.
I know it's cold and
it's
early.
It's absolutely freezing.
But I've got to say, thank you.
Oh, that's
right. Because we want to do hot air balloon and.
No, it ain't bad. It looks pretty good.
It looks amazing.
Oops, sorry, guys.
It's quite safe.
I didn't realise I was heavy enough to jog it.
I could touch it with my hand. Look, we're close,
boy.
But almost. Look, watch.
They kind of look like mushrooms.
They're like little huts.
Yeah, with little triangular roofs on. How far have we travelled?
Probably about 4 kilometres or so, 4 or 5.
Really?
Heading on that way, yeah.
God.
We'll go another 2 or 3 and then look for a nice place to land.
Doesn't feel like we're going that far, so.
No, it's a good speed today. We're probably doing about 15, 18 miles an hour.
Oh, OK. Probably.
No!
If I could just reach to the right.
Nearly.
No.
Oh, no.
Nearly. Oh, up and climbing.
You can really see how deserted this place is now. Nothing for miles. We're coming into land now.
This is the part I've been waiting for, the landing.
Yes.
Here we go. Yes. Lovely little bit
Let's
of
Let's just
rough.
Hope we topple over.
Yep. Lovely bit of rough and bumpy.
Rough and bumpy.
Right, okay.
Here we go.
It's going to be a smooth landing, I think.
Oh.
And a little bit of a bump.
Oh, that was all right. Oh. Did you see that man?
He just flew down that hill.
No, he's going to have a sore bottom.
Ooh.
I think
the that landing, was good. I like that.
I think the landing was one of the best. Well, no, it wasn't the best.
It was
very
good though.
Exciting.
It was exciting. Yeah. I wish it had toppled over a little bit because.
Well, no, we still might topple over, you know. Oh. I think she's making it.
Well done, Emma.
Hey, we toppled.
Good thing.
We packed our bags and headed off to the coastal area of Foccia, where I hope we'll find the most endangered mammal in Europe, the monk seal. We're meeting up with the WWF tomorrow, but before that, me and Brad decided to go fishing.
Brad, put some effort in.
You gotta slow down.
No, you gotta go faster.
Because if you go fast, the net will get tangled and you can't do that because you need to catch a lot of fish today. And then tomorrow morning, Han, we'll come down here on the boat
early
to see if we caught any fish. See, how, you know, we can catch loads of things.
Well, I hope we catch a big fish.
About to see how many fish we've got now. The net is so long, what? It just goes on forever and ever.
It's gonna take us hours. We're doing well, Brad. We've got most of the net in and we've got... Oh, hang on.
I would have thought we got more fish, but...
Hang on about, we've got a whole one in.
Oh, we've got one whole fish.
Oh.
for sure.
Did you catch no fish?
No fish, but one fat octopus. Come on then.
Say goodbye to the fisherman. Thank you very much.
God, it's really nice to be here by the sea, getting away from that desert.
It's a nice little town. I like it here a lot.
We've got to meet the guy around here somewhere.
What, the guy from WWF?
Yep.
WW.
From the WWF.
Well, I tell you what, we'll stop off and get one of these little donut things.
Yeah, definitely. Hello.
Friday.
Two pretzels.
Dos. That's Spanish.
Dos. Oh, I'm a millionaire, look. Now seeing the cash rolling in. I'm just going to be gone after these two pretzels. It's quite expensive out here.
So are we going to see this monk seal or what?
Well, hopefully. Fingers crossed. This is the boat here.
What are the chances of seeing it?
Oh, I don't know. About 50-50. They reckon 50-50, but I think they're lying to me.
All right.
Aaron? Hello?
Hi.
You all right?
What's up?
Go and get your smelly
it's
feet
a nice
out.
Boat, man. I'll take your shoes off. Little sign saying no shoes.
Hello.
Hi. Welcome.
Poor Woofy.
I'm Hannah.
We
nice
need to take
you.
Your feet. Nice meeting you.
Hello, how you doing, mate? You all right, Bradley?
So we're going to check out lots of areas to see if we can see him.
Indeed, we have several places that we can check actually for them. Now we are going to the first spot.
Okay.
And we will be looking through the cliffs. Maybe we'll have a chance to see them there.
Cool.
Yeah.
What's the WWF's involvement with the monk's hill?
Ah, WWF is the major donor of this project that we are carrying out since 1994. And they've been helping us a lot to carry out all the conservation activities to protect the monk's hills here.
So why are they endangered then?
Because of human presence.
Yeah.
There are like pollution, a lot of fisheries going on, and also killing by the fishers because they steal the fish from their nets.
I'm up now, I'm ready to go and find this seal, Spanner.
Let's go. So is this one of the main spots where you look for the monk seal?
Yeah, we often come here twice a week. We come here for observing the seals because we observe main of the seal colonies here.
Right.
And so far we identified 12 of them, and mainly females. And even some of them gave birth here on this peninsula. So it's a very, very important area for us.
Aww.
And if you look at these rocks, you know, you can see the edges of the rocks. You can sometimes very easily encounter them. So if you check now together, maybe we'll have an opportunity to see any of them.
When you come up here, how often do you see them?
Well, especially in October. I mean, whenever we go, we do encounter them in here, actually. But in summertime, 50% have chance,
How big are they?
Well, the biggest one so far has been found more or less 4 meters. So they are huge animals, actually. It's not
it's
very, they're big,
I thought they were quite small.
Yeah.
Why do they call it the monk seal?
Well, actually, there are two stories about it. One is because they look like monk, you know? This is why they're called monk seals. And the other one is because they thought that they are very solitary animals, actually, which we don't believe so, because they are actually very social animals. We saw them in groups, so. But they rest and also give birth on the caves.
Right.
And we'll be checking after this observation now. We'll be going one of the caves and checking if we can encounter any of them.
Right.
We will
see. Oh, so we might
if you're
see
lucky,
one there.
Yeah, if you're lucky, maybe we can see one. Why not? Okay, we are going one of the caves now here. Maybe we can see one seal inside if you're lucky. Huh?
Yeah. Is there any other chance of seeing the seal?
Yeah, we still have a last chance. Maybe we will be seeing them during snorkeling.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right, this is my last chance to find the monk seal. So me and Howard are going to give it our best shot and hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll find the little blighter. Let's go!
Absolutely nothing. I'm really quite disappointed. But I'll keep trying.
It's pitch black dark now and I can't search anymore. I've been searching all day to the last little minute and I haven't found it.
Oh, and oh well.
What do you mean, oh well? Oh well? I'm so disappointed.
You know, well, it's that endangered that we can't even find it. So that's a bad thing. So we need to do some
work. So we need to do something about it.
Yeah.
And you guys out there.
Jinx.
We searched high and low for the monk seal and didn't find it. If we had, this is what it would have looked like. But hopefully, with the work of the WWF, the numbers will increase, and who knows, next time, I might be luckier.
OK, well, Hannah, I know you was disappointed because yesterday you didn't get a chance to see your monk seal, right? Well, I thought that I'd cheer you up a little bit and take you out on a ride of your life. How about that?
I'll race you away, cool. Baby.
Well, all right, then. Let's go! So I think that's it for Turkey, right, Anne?
That's it?
Yeah.
What were your favourite parts?
My favourite parts was definitely jet skiing.
Yeah, skiing was a buzz.
That was cool.
Yeah, and looking for the monk seal. I know we didn't find it, but...
Maybe next time.
You know, yeah.
The hot air ballooning.
The camel riding.
Oh,
the camel riding was camel. The camel riding was funny.
Yeah.
Especially when I nearly fell
off. Didn't we?
Nah, it was cool.
It was a good time.
Well, let's make a little toast.
All right.
With our Turkish tea.
Cool. Cheers, Han.
Cheers, Brad. Cheers, guys.